Welcome to the chemistry requirements for Hayward Salt Chlorinators. This video is provided for you to better understand our products and how they operate. It is best to view this video first before viewing the installation, operation, or troubleshooting videos for Hayward's complete line of salt chlorinators. Make sure to read the installation manuals and quick start guides included with Hayward Salt Chlorinators. This video is designed to serve as a quick overview and does not replace or supersede the detailed installation and operation requirements set forth in the product owner's and installation manual. To obtain a free additional copy of a manual for any of our chlorinators, please visit Hayward.com. Before installing a Hayward salt chlorination system, we first need to balance the pool chemistry. This will ensure proper operation and increase the effectiveness of the system once installed. Make sure to follow the manufacturer's safety procedures and recommendations for all water chemistry chemicals added to the pool. Most professional pool dealers can test your water and provide results and recommendations if needed. To ensure proper operation, make sure the water is free of all chlorine substitutes. If a chlorine substitute, such as a biguanide, was being used prior, consult the chemical manufacturer's instructions regarding safe removal practices. Once removed from the water, be sure to thoroughly clean the filtration system, complying with the filter manufacturer's instructions. The next step is to analyze the water, paying close attention to the chemistry table located on the back of the owner's manual. After the results of the analysis are available, start balancing the cyanuric acid, calcium hardness, and salt levels first. The recommended calcium hardness level is 200 to 400 parts per million. If too low, the water will attempt to pull calcium from other possible sources like pool plaster. If the level is low, add calcium obtained from a professional pool dealer to bring levels up to 200 to 400 parts per million. If concentrations are too high, increased scaling of the turbo cell and pool surfaces will likely occur. If the calcium hardness exceeds 400 parts per million, partially drain the water and replenish with fresh water to dilute. The next step is to identify the salt concentration in the pool. These systems are designed to operate between 2700 and 3400 parts per million. If this pool was being treated with chlorine, then salt may already be present as a byproduct. It is important to never assume that the water is free of salt. If salt concentration exceeds 3400 parts per million, partially drain the water and replenish with fresh water to dilute. If more salt is required, follow the salt addition table located in the owner's manual. It is important to add salt that is 99% pure. Additionally, the salt should not be iodized, contain any anti-caking additives, or yellow prussiate of soda because these additives can cause staining. It is also recommended never to use rock salt. Buying salt from a professional pool dealer will assure you are getting the right type. Cyanuric acid levels, also known as conditioner or stabilizer, should not exceed 80 parts per million, with a recommended level between 30 and 50 parts per million. If too much cyanuric acid is present, please partially drain the water and replace with fresh water to dilute. If the concentration is low, add cyanuric acid to the pool using the stabilizer addition chart located in the manual. Cyanuric acid can be obtained from your professional pool dealer. Once the cyanuric acid level has been balanced, identify the dissolved metals concentration in the pool water. Have your water tested by a pool professional to determine if metals are present in the pool. Source water and other chemicals like some algaecides can contribute to the existence of dissolved metals. Additives to remove metals from the pool can be obtained from a professional pool dealer. Alkalinity and pH are the next two considerations. In order to regulate pH drift, a common symptom experienced when the alkalinity is too high, a combination of muriatic acid and aerating the water will drop the bicarbonates present in the pool water, which in turn will lower the alkalinity levels. If the alkalinity is too low, add baking soda to increase. Once the alkalinity is balanced, the pH will soon follow suit. Muriatic acid will lower pH and soda ash will raise the level. If more information is needed, please contact your pool professional for more guidance. The final step in balancing the pool is to measure the chlorine level. it is recommended to start the chlorine generator with at least 1 to 3 parts per million of free chlorine in the water. This will ensure that any water situation needing chlorine has been satisfied before starting the electronic chlorine generator. For professional help and service, go to Hayward.com and select Dealer Locator, which you will see at the top left of the website navigation bar. Next, provide the postal code of where the system is installed, as well as 1. A search radius, 2. Pool type, 3. Product repair and service, and 4. Chlorinators. Lastly, select Submit and you will see all local Hayward authorized service centers who can assist with the salt chlorinator installation, operation, and service. Remember to visit Hayward Pool Products at www.hayward.com along with our social media sites for helpful information about your Hayward products.